Hello!
Welcome to Olé Plus Essays. The best among the best. My name is Julie and I will be your instructor as we read through Database Design Upgrade. The article source is embedded in the video description below. Feel free to read along. Please note that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay for as little as $10 a page at Olé Plus Essays. The link is in the description. This template is color-coded to differentiate between boilerplate language, instructions, sample language, and hyperlinks. In consideration of those reviewing a black-and-white hard copy of this document, we have also differentiated these sections of the document using various fonts and styles. Details are described below. Please remove the template instructions when the document is finalized. Standard boilerplate language has been developed for this management plan. This language is identified in black Arial font and will not be modified without the prior approval of the OSI Project Management Office, PMO. If the project has identified a business need to modify the standard boilerplate language, the request must be communicated to the PMO for review. Instructions for using this template are provided in Blue Times New Roman font and describe general information for completing this management plan. All blue text should be removed from the final version of this plan. Sample language is identified in red italic Arial font. This language provides suggestions for completing specific sections. All red text should be replaced with project-specific information and the font color replaced with black text. Hyperlinks are annotated in purple underlined Arial text and can be accessed by following the on-screen instructions. To return to the original document after accessing a hyperlink, click on the back arrow on your browser's toolbar. The file download dialog box will open. Click on Open to return to this document. 1. Introduction. 1.1 Purpose. The purpose of the database design project is to create a database design at the request of the vice president of XYZ company that will track sales information for the Scruggs company. The purpose is to design a database that incorporates the company's current POS system, accounting system and commission system in one database for ease of access for users and management, eliminate redundancies between current systems, and allow for a more accurate, trackable and streamlined use of data. The objective of the Scruggs Company database project is to develop a robust and efficient deductive database system, which incorporates and enhances current systems to meet the needs of management, outside vendors and other stakeholders. The Sales Performance Database project has been assigned by the company CEO, Tom Scruggs. 1.2 Scope. The PMP describes the overall purpose and scope of the database design project. It provides how the project will be organized, staffed, and describes who the project stakeholders are. The PMP further details the methodology for the database project that will be employed for each phase of the project lifecycle, as well as a brief description of each of the component plans of the PMP. 1.3 References. Project Management Institute, PMI, Project Management Book of Knowledge, PMBOK 3rd Edition, Software Engineering Institute, SCI, at Carnegie Mellon University. 1.3.1 Project Centralized Document Repository. Refer to the WorkSite repository located at the Scruggs Company head office, managed by Project Design Team, for all project-specific documentation. 2. Project Planning. The Database Design Project Management Plan is based primarily on the project management processes described in the PMBOK 4RD edition. The methodology for planning the project utilizes the aspects of the PMBOK where applicable to the database design project based on its size, complexity, and staff resources. 2.1 Scope Management. 2.1.1 Scope Statement. The scope of the database design project is to procure and implement a centralized, integrated database management system at the Scruggs Company. This integrated database system will adequately track sales, commissions, inventory, item sales, purchasing, or customer activity in any other retail stores, allowing management to access all of the key metrics for the sales department as well as ensure that commissions are monitored and tracked according to employee sales. The scope of the database design project is to secure and retain project approval and funding. Define business requirements for the database design. Upgrade services to implement database design. Ensure verification and validation, and independent project oversight are performed. procure a vendor to design, customize, test and implement the database design and the needed interfaces to and from existing POS, accounting, and sales systems. Ensure the program organization and staff is prepared for the database design implementation. Retire the previous system, S, software and documentation components. Complete the database design post-implementation and evaluation report. 2.1.2 Scope Management. The database design project scope will be managed through the various management plans, project documents, reviews, and change control processes established throughout the project's phases. The project plans will be developed to ensure that the project scope baseline is maintained and consistent. Project documents will be reviewed to ensure the scope is established in the database design project charter, feasibility study report, and in this project management plan is not inadvertently altered or changed. The project scope will primarily be managed through the project schedule reviews such as weekly status meetings, bi-weekly vendor meetings, and monthly steering committee meetings, and through the change control process. Communication will play a key role in scope management. The project has established several forms of verbal and written communication described in the database design communication plan to ensure stakeholders, sponsors, executive management, team members, external agencies, and vendors involved in the database design project have a clear understanding of the project scope. There are so many elements that could affect a project scope within a project that the very nature of scope dictates that its management is integrated in all aspects of the project. Although the objective is to have little or no change to the project scope, some changes should be anticipated. In the event that scope changes occur, the changes will be identified through the change control process established in the database design configuration management plan. As changes to technical and business requirements, hardware, software, documents, and system design are identified, the impact to the project scope will be assessed and addressed during the formal change control process. Scope changes will be classified as internal or external, and project level or management level. The following defines what constitutes an internal versus external scope change. Internal scope change, change that is generated or results within the database design project organization and structure within the OSI. Examples are changes in business policies, OSI policies, functionality, technical design, resources, etc. External scope change, change that is generated or results from entities external to the database design project organization and structure. These changes may be generated or result from external control agencies, legislation, court orders, state mandates and policy, public sector, or environment. Both the database design team and the database design vendor will identify any potential internal scope changes. Any external scope changes will be identified through the Executive Steering Committee, Project Director, sponsors, and the database design project managers. The project level scope changes, internal or external, are considered those changes that meet the established criteria and can be approved by the Project Change Control Board as described in the Configuration Management Plan. Management level scope changes, internal and external, will constitute those changes that require the approval of the Management or Steering Committee Change Control Board as described in the Configuration Management Plan. 2.1.3 Work Breakdown Structure. The WBS is a hierarchical decomposition of the work to be executed by the project team to accomplish the project objectives and create the required deliverables. The WBS organizes and defines the total scope of project. The WBS subdivides the project work into smaller, more manageable pieces of work. The database design project work breakdown structure is provided in Appendix A. 2.1.4 Formal acceptance of scope. The formal acceptance of the project scope was accomplished through the database design project charter. The database design project charter was prepared and submitted by the database design project managers and the database design project director. The charter was distributed and coordinated through the project sponsors and executive management staff with final approval by the project director. 2.2 Time management. Time management includes the processes required to accomplish timely completion of the project. Time management processes would be the schedule development, management and control throughout the project lifecycle. The time management of the project centers on the overall project schedule. The database design project used a top-down approach to develop the project work breakdown structure that was used as the foundation for the development of the overall project schedule. The project consists of six major parts: 1. Infrastructure upgrades. 2. Data center implementation. 3. Database design vendor development. 4. OSI management. 5. Verification and validation. And 6. Independent project oversight consultant, as shown in the work breakdown structure, Appendix A. These six major parts were then broken down further into the major activities that make up each of these parts. With the exception of the database design vendor development activities, all the major activities were broken down into subordinate activities and finally down to the task level. Each of the database design team members was then assigned specific areas to identify the activities and tasks in their respective areas. The schedule provided by database design vendor was used to establish the database design vendor development part, and the data center provided a schedule for the data center implementation part. A combination of bottom-up and top-down approach was taken to establish the durations depending on the activity, task, or dependency. Through several iterations and alignment of activities and tasks, the overall database design project schedule was produced and established. The database design project uses Microsoft Project as a tool to integrate, monitor, manage, and control the overall database design project schedule. The database design schedule is password protected to allow only write access to the project scheduler and the technical project manager. All other database design project team members have read-only access. This prevents any unauthorized or inadvertent changes to the schedule. The overall database design project schedule is base-aligned, and any changes or variations to the schedule are reflected and captured in Microsoft Project, and can be viewed using the tracking Gantt view function in the application. The project scheduler will assess schedule impacts on a weekly basis, monitor the progress, and identify areas where the schedule is or may fall behind. The project scheduler will bring any items that potentially impact the schedule's critical path to the database design user and technical project manager's attention. The project scheduler will use Microsoft Project to continually reassess the project's critical path and recommend actions to avoid schedule slips or mitigate impacts. The schedule will follow a formal change control process for any proposed changes to the schedule. The change control process for the project's schedule is described later in this document. 2.3 Cost management. Cost management is to ensure the project and its contractors will complete the project within budget. Cost management also includes analysis of options and issues to determine the potential effect on the project's budget and operations. The database design cost management plan will be provided as a separate plan and addresses the how project cost will be managed and controlled for the database design project. 2.4 Quality management. Quality management will define, measure, and improve the quality of the project's processes and products in order to fulfill the success criteria. Quality management establishes the processes by which project products and processes must adhere to specified requirements and established plans throughout the project lifecycle. The database design quality management plan will be provided as a separate plan. The database design vendor will provide a quality management plan for their portion of the project as a deliverable product of the contract. 2.5 Staff management. Staff management plan identifies the process and procedures used to manage staff throughout the project's life. The plan describes the planning and acquisition of both state staff and consulting staff, describes the responsibilities assigned to each staff, and discusses transition of staff to other assignments. The database design staff management plan will be provided as a separate plan and addresses the how staff acquisition, training, tracking and management and transition will be managed and controlled for the database design project. 2.6 Risk management. The risk management plan includes processes by which potential threats to project success are identified, mitigated, or eliminated. Risk considerations will include technical, management, solicitation and contracting, performance, budget resources, political, natural disasters, security, etc. Risk management is an integral part of project management from project initiation through project completion. Refer to the Database Design Risk Management Plan for more information on risk management. 2.7 Communication management. The communication management plan includes processes by which project information is developed, maintained, and managed for both internal and external project stakeholders. Refer to the database design communication management plan for more information on communication management. 2.8 Configuration Management. Configuration management establishes the processes by which system documentation items are defined, maintained, and managed. Refer to the database design configuration management plan for more information on configuration management. 2.9 Contract Management. Contract management identifies the activities to be performed or initiated by project staff to manage, track, amend, and close a contract. Contractor activities and activities performed by other state organizations are discussed at a high level only to facilitate an understanding of the complete process. Refer to the database design contract management plan for more information on contract management. 2.10 Governance plan and issue escalation process. Governance plan identifies the key governance roles and responsibilities for the project and covers who by role is responsible for approving project documents, establishing contracts in support of the project, approving contractor deliverables, and making the final decision to accept the automated system and contractor products. The Executive Steering Committee is the primary entity within this project guiding the governance processes. The issue escalation process identifies the governance and escalation process that will be used to manage issues, problems, change, or approvals. Refer to the database design governance plan and issue escalation process for more information. 2.11 Database design organizational structure. The following is a list of internal and external organizations impacted by the database design project. Other entities include OSI, for project management, Department of Technology Services, DTS, for system and network hosting, Department of General Services, DGS, for procurement support, Department of Finance, Budgetary, and the Office of Chief Information Office, OCIO, for project oversight. List organizational structure here. 2.12 Project Assumptions and Constraints. 2.12.1 Project Assumptions. In order to execute and accomplish the project within the time constraints is based on the following assumptions. Control agencies have approved an accelerated schedule of approval and procurement. Control agencies provide approvals by MMDDYYYY and funding by MMDDYYYY. Potential vendor has a developed system that contains the majority of the components to satisfy the business requirements. Vendors do not contest the procurement and ultimate award of contract. Vendors will clearly understand the requirements defined in the RFP. 2.13 Project constraints. The major constraints facing the project are time constraint ordered by the program. The system must operate within the electrical capacity and environment provided or planned at the location facilities. The system must be implemented and maintained with the funds approved by the state. Resources to support the database design project are limited to existing staff and skill levels available. Control agencies, Office of Chief Information Office, OCIO, Department of Finance, DOF, and Department of General Services, DGS, must review and approve key deliverables before proceeding to the next phase of the project. The database design vendor, the selected bidder, will conform to IEEE or equivalent and PMI or equivalent standards, per direction from the DOF, OCIO, and DGS. 3. Project Execution 3.1 Project Management Plan Execution. Describe the project management plan execution phase and the activities involved. The project management plan execution will be initiated through a database design project kickoff meeting. The project kickoff meeting provides the forum to integrate all parties involved in the project and focus everyone toward a common set of project objectives. The objective of the kickoff meeting is to provide background and an overview of the project, and to establish a common set of management processes and procedures that the project will use to execute the project through implementation. Completion of this meeting constitutes the formal execution of the project management plan. The project management plan will continue to be executed throughout the project through the established processes and procedures documented in the various management plans developed by the database design team and the database design vendor. The database design project manager is responsible to monitor the execution of the plan and will use status meetings, reports, and project metrics to ensure that the project management plan is being executed. The various meetings and reports are described in the Database Design Communication Plan. 3.2 Information Distribution, describe how information will be distributed throughout the project lifecycle. The Database Design Communication Plan describes how the information distribution will be executed for the project. In addition, the Database Design Configuration Plan identifies the various project records and describes how these items will be accessed and maintained. 3.3 Application Customization, describe the application customization that may be applicable to your project during the execution phase. The Database Design Project is a solution with some customization. The database design vendor is accomplishing the customization to the application. As such, the methodology being used for the technical development on the database design project is primarily utilizing the database design vendor's processes, with database design technical staff providing oversight of the database design vendor. The detailed areas of the technical execution will be found and described in the following documents: System Requirement Specification, Detailed Design Specification, Database Schema, Test and Evaluation Master Plan, Data Conversion Plan, User Reference Guides, Training Plan, Implementation Plan. In addition to these documents being developed over the course of the project, several technical review meetings and work sessions are scheduled to review, assess, and monitor the technical aspects of the project. 4. Project Control, describe the change control process that is necessary for controlling factors that create changes to make sure those changes are beneficial, determining whether a change has occurred, and managing the approved changes, including when they occur. 4.1 Integrated Change Control, the description on how integrated change control is accomplished can be found in the Configuration Management Plan. 4.2 Scope Change Control, the scope change control will follow the processes and procedures described in the Database Design Configuration Management Plan. The project level scope changes, internal or external, are considered those changes that meet the established criteria and can be approved by the Project Change Control Board as described in the Database Design Configuration Management Plan. Management level scope changes, internal and external, will constitute those changes that require the approval of the Management or Steering Committee Change Control Board as described in the Database Design Configuration Management Plan. Refer to the Database Design Configuration Management Plan for the formal change control process. The magnitude and overall impact as a result of scope variation needs to be identified to assess the impact to the project in terms of cost, schedule, or performance. The database design project managers and team members will evaluate and assess the magnitude and overall impact for each change proposed, initiated, or imposed. The performance measurement in terms of the degree, magnitude, and the severity, overall impact, of the individual scope changes will be used to assess the variation in scope. The scope variation will be monitored and tracked through each phase of the project using the measured impact of cost, schedule, and performance attributed to scope changes. 4.3 Schedule Control, the database design project schedule will be monitored, tracked, and controlled by the database design project scheduler. The Database Design Project Scheduler will establish and maintain the overall project schedule using Microsoft Project. Once the final project schedule is established and approved, the baseline will be set. Progress and schedule changes will be tracked against the baseline to identify variances. As part of the time management process and procedures, the Database Design Project Scheduler will use established forms within the project to manage the Database Design Project Schedule. The following will be utilized to monitor and track the project schedule: weekly database design team status meetings, bi-weekly database design team vendor status meetings, vendor monthly status reports, daily communication. As required, all potential impacts to the project schedule must be reported, verbally or written, to the database design project scheduler prior to a schedule slip occurring. Only activities and tasks on the overall project schedule must be reported to the Database Design Project Scheduler. Project schedule change requests must be submitted to the Database Design Project Scheduler and include the following: the activity deliverable milestone impacted, how and why the change is being requested, alternatives to meet the original end date, revised end date, action plan to meet the revised end date, approval, through the change control process described in the Configuration Management Plan is required to change the overall project schedule and/or baseline. 4.4 Performance Reporting. The project performance reporting will be accomplished through established status meetings, reports, and internal project tracking systems. The following are a list of mechanisms used that provide performance reporting: database design weekly status meeting, database design vendor bi-weekly status meeting, monthly steering committee meeting, database design monthly status report, OCIO monthly status report, vendor monthly status report, action item tracking system, risk database tracking system, deliverable tracking system. The two major performance metrics being reported are cost and schedule. The cost is being tracked in terms of variances to the approved budget and spend plan. The schedule is being monitored in terms of variances to the established baseline. 5. Unanticipated tasks. As the project evolves, items may arise which would cause unanticipated tasks, scope changes, or enhancements that may be beyond the original contract. The process for addressing unanticipated tasks, scope changes, or enhancements that are beyond the scope of the original contract will be to follow the scope change and contract change procedures described. Enhancements beyond the original contract will be prioritized and postponed until after the implementation of the database design project unless the enhancement is critical to the successful implementation. If the enhancement is critical to the success of the database design implementation, then the scope, cost, and schedule control procedures will be followed. 6. Project schedule. Refer to the database design project schedule for the detailed overall project activities, tasks, and milestones. The high-level depiction of the major activities and milestones can be found in Appendix B. 7. Phase closeout and lessons learned. Phase closeout and formal lessons learned are project management activities performed at the end of each OSI lifecycle phase to ensure the proper closure of a current lifecycle phase before proceeding to the next phase. Closeout activities include review of all goals and objectives of the phase, final status and closure of issues and risks related to the phase, and review of documentation and files for archival or destruction. 7.1.1 Conducting formal lessons learned. At the close of each life cycle phase, the project prepares a lessons learned report. This includes an analysis of project objectives achieved during the completed phase. Lessons learned reports are imported into the best practices worksite repository for use by other projects and identifying areas for process improvement action. 7.1.2 Contract closeout. The following closeout items referenced in the contract management plan template for this function should be reviewed for applicability, tailored, and summarized. The summary should describe actions taken by the project office in performing closeout for each of the items below, as applicable. Contract final reports, contractor evaluation, invoices and disencumbering funds, archiving contractor records. The following items from the database design contract management plan are established for specific instruction related to contract closeout. The following tracking and execution items referenced in the contract management plan template, for consultants, should be reviewed for applicability, tailored, and summarized. The summary should describe actions to be taken by the project office in performing closeout for each of the following items, as applicable. Contract final reports, contractor evaluation, invoices and disencumbering funds, archiving contractor records. The following items from the database design contract management plan, for consultants, are established for specific instruction related to contract closeout. 7.1.3 Administrative closure. The administrative closure is the process of preparing closure documentation of the project deliverables for the customer as well as taking other administrative actions to ensure that the project and its asset are redistributed. Financial closure and audit, completing and terminating the financial and budgetary aspects of the project being performed. Archiving, creating and storing a hard and/or soft copy of all documentation related to the project, personnel and facilities. Reassignment and reallocation of personnel and equipment that have been used during the project. Please be aware that the free essay that you were just reading was not written by us. This essay, and all of the others available to view on the website, were provided to us by students in exchange for services that we offer. This relationship helps our students to get an even better deal while also contributing to the biggest free essay resource in the UK. Thank you for taking your time to listen to me. I hope you enjoyed learning about database design upgrade as much as I did. Kindly remember that you can get a custom, plagiarism-free essay at All A Plus Essays for as little as $10. The link is in the description. See you next time.